I am a socialist. I work for the betterment of this society. I give my money for the betterment of this society.
After a decade.
Doctor, having a very bad stomachache, could you please help me?
You know what I think? I think you have a deficiency of vitamin M.
What? Vitamin M?
Money! It is crucial for everybody's survival, and that is what capitalists do.
To counter what Team A said, let me tell you how human psychology works. It is proved that a person does not mind to be poor as long as everyone around them is poor.
Jo tera hai wo, wait, mera nahi hai. Lekin jo mera hai, wo tera already ban chuka hai. What belongs to the capitalists can never be ours. But what is ours has already become theirs. We can never touch the crores of rupees of income and profit that they make. Whereas all that is ours is in their control.
Denmark, socialist. Norway, socialist. Sweden, socialist. Iceland, socialist. And Finland, also socialist.
The Bhagavad Gita tells us, Samatvam Yogam Uchyate. This means that equilibrium is the most important thing. I think when God gives you advice, free advice, without the heavy price of 200 years of tapas, it's best we take it.
Today, we're not standing here because some socialists sowed some charity towards us.
Talk about India. It is the seventh largest nation in the world. And while all your introductions sounded really beautiful, we are not living in a fairy tale magical world. We are in reality and we need practical economic solutions to solve our country's problems and not happy-go-lucky, I will feed you, you feed me type of attitude, because it does not work out in India, is what we are trying to say.
You want an economic solution where one man becomes super rich and the rest becomes super poor, then that's what's going to happen with the capitalists that you want.
The progress of any society or anything indirectly depends on the eradication of social evils, and then comes finance. All we know is that the capitalists are here. Where they are today is because of their basic socialistic nature.
Upliftment of the society to a moderate level is better than upliftment of one to a superlative degree and starvation of the rest. As my friend said, equilibrium is what we need, not inequality. The richer are becoming richer and the poor are becoming poorer.
Talking about India's development, we wouldn't be developing if it hadn't been for income, tax, GDP, national income. All this is contributed only by capitalists, not by socialists.
My friends in Team A, I would just like to clarify that a socialist is not a person, it's the side of a person. If Ratan Tata did anything charitable, it wasn't the capitalist in him, but the socialist in him. A socialist is the human side of a person, and the capitalist is the animal in him.
Socialism is fair and democratic because it believes in equality to all. So if we adopt capitalism, what are we going to do? We are going to go against the very basis of our country and our constitution, also put everyone else's lives at stake.
Coming to Indian economy, we have two types of sectors, private and public. Do you know that the private sector is a bigger sector? It gives more employment, it gets in larger companies, and this in turn helps out the public sector.
And to explain the working of a company better, unless the whole company is stable, unless everyone in the company is working together, the capitalist is not making any money.
Capitalistic society is all about financial dictatorship. While a socialist society is a classless society, it's all about equality and equilibrium.
My friends in Team A, you talked about privatization. In Bolivia, the water supply was privatized and water bills rose to 1,000 rupees in a country where the average income is 5,000 rupees. That's what privatization does. Privatization is the basis of capitalism, and that's what happens when you privatize industries.
Moreover, if a person were to be truly capitalist, he would exploit the very nature that each of us is trying to conserve today. And if all of us were capitalists, if USA was capitalist, there wouldn't be a single tree alive.
We agree that socialists are needed today, but what we are trying to say is capitalists are more important, because without them you cannot have socialists in society.